Good morning, Sir Winchester, and welcome to the program. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah, good morning to everyone. It's an honor for me to be here, and I would like to envelop the idea of recycling here in the Philippines, especially for the plastic waste or the single-use plastics that we are used to say now to everyone.
Mm-hmm. Our pleasure having you here in the program as well. Now, let's focus on waste recycling, Sir Winchester. We've been hearing this for a long time, but is it really being consciously practiced in the Philippines?
Well, actually, it's really been a problem of our countrymen for a very long time, because we are used to buy small packaging materials because of the growth problem here in the Philippines. Well, in fact, this is not a problem anymore, because our advocacy is really to tackle a one-stop shop wherein we can accept all types of plastic waste and recycle them and turn them into products that the communities can use. Especially right now, the Department of Education lacks around 5 million school chairs all over the country, and we are here to support them and make sure that the school chairs will be given. Especially our design, it's interlocking parts, so whenever there's a part that can be broken, we can replace it, and the part that was broken, we can recycle it. It's an endless possibility altogether.
Mm-hmm. I'm curious, sir, where do you get the recyclable materials for you to turn into better reusable items?
That's a good question. We are tied up with some multinational companies here in the country, and some of them are from local government units that are really has a higher awareness of sorting and collecting the plastic waste in their own location. And at the same time, we are getting it from walk-ins, wherein they are really tired of bringing the plastic waste in the dump site or in some of the trucks that are being used, and it's not being sorted anymore. So everyone is ganging up already in making sure that the plastic waste will not end up in the landfill or in the ocean turning out as a marine litter, or later on it's a microplastic that we can eat later on.
Mm-hmm. There are studies that show the Philippines is the highest plastic waste producer in the whole world. This is actually very concerning, because for a very small country, we produce a lot of pollution that we need to at least control. Does the government have policies that are being enforced to strengthen efforts on waste recycling?
Yes, right now there's what we call the extended producers law, responsibility law, wherein the multinational companies are looking for a PRO, a producers responsibility organization, to look so that those organizations will be the one to recycle the packaging material that they produce. Mm-hmm. And right now we are strategically located in those areas wherein they can bring in their plastic waste materials, so, and then we can recycle them all together.
Mm-hmm. We just passed the law banning the use of a single, or at least limiting the use of single-use plastic. You mentioned earlier that there are walk-ins for people who have materials that can be recycled once again. If, let's say, somebody from the LGU make a group effort, a conscious effort, to collect recyclable materials and then approach EnviroTech to give this to them, do they get something in return from your company?
Right now, we are only accepting all donations, because we believe that it is a responsibility to make sure that those items will not end up in the landfill. And as a recycler, I can accept all of them from number one to number seven, especially the foil packaging or the multi-layer plastic packaging. Mm-hmm. We can accept them, and then we can convert them into useful products.
Mm-hmm. But these products that EnviroTech comes up with, are these being sold, or are these also given back to the community?
We can apply them because the government has a program we call the Adopt a School program. So anybody can join in, and then they can refund the cost that they made from it from a rebate in tax form. So it's really a win-win situation for everyone.
Mm-hmm, that's very nice. Your company, Sir Win EnviroTech, works with local governments in the private sector to recycle plastic waste. Can you tell us more about that, please?
When I started this in the year 2010, nobody believed that I can produce different products out of the plastic waste. Yeah, it's my dad's advocacy as well, because my dad is an inspiration to me, mm-hmm. because he started this in the late 80s, and I can see that we have a lot of plastic waste that can be recycled, because right now it's just a mere 9%. What happened to the 91%? It's just in the landfill. Mm-hmm. So my idea is really to recover them, and then when I presented this to some of the LGUs, they were so happy that I can recycle all the plastic waste materials, because some of the recycling companies are not accepting all the materials, especially the EPS or the styrofoam that we have right now. So styrofoam is included in our process. So what I can offer really is a one-stop solution, a 100% recovery of the plastic waste.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how can you emphasize to Filipinos that waste recycling is beneficial to three aspects? Number one, for nature, economy, and the community.
Well, of course, when we recover the plastic waste, you are really cleaning the environment and the ozone layers. We can help reduce it. And number two, we can serve the communities, because we are helping create jobs as well. And then number three, we can market it at a lower price, because we are really after the reducing of the backlog of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. All right, and with that, I will let you go. Thank you so much for your time and for teaching us, Sir Winchester Lemon, the CEO of Envirotech. Have a good day ahead, sir.
Thank you very much for having me.